In this video, I'll discuss how to encrypt and decrypt strings and files in Python. The method being used is an implementation of AES, which means the key that we use to encrypt will be also used to decrypt. I'll also show you how to safely store these keys so you can remember them for later. First, you'll need to install the cryptography package. Open up CMD and type python-m pip install cryptography. Make sure no errors occurred by looking at the last lines. It'll state that it was installed correctly. To make sure it's working properly, open IDLE or a Python shell and import cryptography. First, you'll need to get a key to encrypt and decrypt with. This is like a password, but in a special format. Open a new Python script and import fernet from cryptography.fernet. Set key to a new key generated by fernet. Make the script print the key and then save the script. You'll notice every time you run it, the key will change. This is because the generate key function creates a random key every time you call it. The key generator is a bytes object of a base64 encoded string. Since a new key is given every time generate key is called, you'll want to save a key so you can encrypt and decrypt with the same key. If you do not encrypt and decrypt with the same key, an exception will occur stating that you have provided an invalid token. To save the key, we can easily write it to a file. Since the key is a bytes object, open the file with the write bytes permission so we can directly write bytes. After opening, write the key and then close the file. If you open the file that was written to, you can see the key is now in there. After saving your key in a file, you'll later want to read the file to get the key. To do this, we can simply open the file with read bytes, call .read on the file to get all the contents, and then close it. The key will now be in the key variable and should be the same as what we put in. To check it is the same, you can add a print statement. Now every time you run this, the key from the file should be printed. In some circumstances, you may want to use a password to create a key. This is sometimes a good idea as you don't have to save the key, and every time you create a key using the password, it'll be the same. Import the classes and methods that I import here. Create a variable with your password. You can use the input keyword to get input from a user or just set it like I have. Next, you want to encode the string to create a bytes object. Now set a salt. This will need to be the same every time, but I recommend using something different to my one. The salt also needs to be a bytes object. This can be done by putting a B in front of the string. It is recommended to use os.urandom to create a salt. For this demonstration, I'll quickly call this method and copy the value over. Now pass the parameters I have passed to pbkdf2hmac and store the return object. To get the key, we can now pass the password to kdef.derive and encode it using base64. If you print out the key, save and run, you'll see the key is the same every time due to the same password being used. If we change the password, the key will also change. First, I'll show you how to encrypt and decrypt strings to get the basics out of the way and then files. I'll use the key that was saved in the file previously for the rest of these examples. Create a variable with your message and then call .encode on it to convert it to bytes. Now create an object of fernet passing the key. We can simply call this object's encrypt method passing the message. The return of this will be the encrypted message. Print this message and then save and run the script to look at it. Once again, we can see that it returned a bytes object, so if you wanted, you can save in a file using bytes read and write permissions like before. To decrypt the encrypted message, we just need to call the decrypt method passing the encrypted message on a fernet object that was provided the same key. For demonstration purposes, I'll get the key from the file and create the fernet object again. This is not required, but it's just to prove that the method works. After getting the key again and creating a new fernet object, call decrypt on the new fernet object passing the encrypted message. If you print out the results of this, you'll notice that it's a bytes object. To make this a string again, call .decode on the variable and print it out again. When running, you'll now see that the original message is printed. Encrypting a file is very similar to a string. Instead of encoding a string, we can just read from a file that has read bytes permissions. This will return bytes, so we can pass it straight into the encrypt method. I've created a file at test.txt to demonstrate this working. Make sure you have written the key and then read in the data from a file. I'll use the open keyword to make things more compact. Next, create a fernet object like before and encrypt just like I did before. Now you'll want to write the encrypted data to a new file. Make sure to use the write bytes permission as the data returned is bytes. Finally, save and run the script. Looking at the file created, this is now encrypted data. You can delete the original if you wish. Now to decrypt, we need to simply read the data from the encrypted file, decrypt it like before, and then write it back out. If you open the new file generated, it'll be the same as the original file. If you want any of the code from this video, it can all be found in the article I wrote on this topic linked in the description. Also, if you have any issues or questions regarding the topic of this video, feel free to leave a comment and I'll try my best to help you.